We'll start then. Welcome to the meeting of the Liverpool City Combined Authority. As always, I need to inform everybody present that this meeting will be broadcast live to the Combined Authority website and available for subsequent viewing. And by entering this room, you'll consent to being filmed and to the possible use of those images and sound recordings for filming purposes. Also, can we welcome Jackie Sinnott, who's the interim CEO, and to Lynn Morton. Lynn, is this your first meeting as well? Or have you been here before? And to Lynn as well. You're both very welcome. Can members and officers please assure that you press the microphone before speaking and then turn it off afterwards? And finally, can everyone ensure that their phone is switched to silent, please? Items 8, 9 and 10 contain exempt appendices due to the information linked to the financial or business affairs of a person. Therefore, if we wish to discuss the content of these appendices, Jill will guide us through what we need to do at that time. And just before we begin the formalities of the agenda of today's meeting, it was with great sadness that we learned of the sad passing of Mary Twigg. It was not only Derek Twigg's wife, but also worked alongside Derek in Halton for many years. And on another sad note, we are, of course, 1 week from the senseless killings that took place on London Bridge. And our hearts go out to all of those connected to the tragedy. And we stand in solidarity, of course, with them. I've sent a note to both Mercy Calm and to the Metro Mayor of Cambridge and Peterborough, James Palmer, as the victims of both students at that university there. So I think it'd be appropriate, colleagues, if we stand for a minute's silence. Thanks, colleagues, impeccably observed as always. This is our last meeting before Christmas, so on behalf of the Combined Authority, the leaders present, we wish everybody all the very best for Christmas and a happy and healthy new year. Item one is apologies for absence.
Thank you, Chair. I've received apologies from Councillor Baines, Councillor Hardy, Councillor Russ Bowden, and Councillor Spurling.
Any further apologies? No, okay. Of course, Ian. Two is declarations of interest. Three are the minutes of the meeting of the Combined Authority from the 1st of November. Can these be agreed? Pages 1 to 12, please. Four, we're going to start by talking about. 1 week on from the verdict of the retrial of Commander David Duckenfield, obviously we're all very cognizant of the fact that there are ongoing legal procedures in probably criminal cases, so we have to be very careful what we say. But I think in regard to what came out of the press and the families made their feelings very clear, and I can speak for everyone when I say that we, of course, will always continue to support them. They have our deepest sympathies and support. Along with Margaret Aspinall and Andy Burden, I've written to the party leaders and asked that whoever's Prime Minister on the 13th of December, when we wake up, that they enact the Hillsborough Law, which calls for equal funding so that there's parity of access for legal representation. For something called a duty of candour, so that any public servant who intentionally misleads the public would be liable to prosecution and full disclosure of all documentation in such instances, and hopefully therefore we'll get a level playing field future cases that we all would like to see. In regard to what happened at the Environmental Summit, which was at the start of November, we held our first ever Liverpool City Region Environmental Summit, and it was hugely successful on the day. And I think by the end of the event, everyone was more or less singing from the same hymn sheet. We announced a Green Community Fund to support some of our fantastic local organisations who are already doing great things, as well as the LCR Climate Partnership, and that's a newly announced body which ensure that it meets, or we meet, the aims to become a net zero carbon by 2040. Over the last few weeks, I went to both St Helens and Nosey Business Awards. Both absolutely fantastic. The leaders were there, and I'm sure they'll agree with me that they were both brilliant and showcased what those boroughs' businesses have to offer. And following off from that, I spoke to Wirral Chamber members to explain to them about the £75 million we recently announced at the last CA for business support across the city region. Last week we launched the Poverty and Life Chances Action Group, and it follows the release of statistics earlier in the year that said that just on a third of children living in Halton, Nosey, Liverpool, St Helens, Seven and Wirral are growing up in poverty. And it's nothing short of a national disgrace, and we hope that by pulling together politicians, practitioners, academics, trade unionists and faith leaders from across all six districts of the Liverpool City region, that we can begin to turn the tide on those very depressing statistics. As part of the ongoing community engagement activity that I do, I went to some great places. I visited Calderstones, Mansion and Allerton. Being there, Joe, was with Andy Burnham. Burnham thinks we've got someone to come a tourist attraction in its own right. I went to Kirby High School in Nosey to see the fantastic work being done by an organisation called Innovate Here, and you all know about them. We try to encourage young girls to get into STEM. Went to Southport College to view a newly opened gas and plumber facility that had £400,000 of CA funding to do that. And we're very, very grateful for it, believe me. And then we went to Tubrook Children's Centre, where we saw some absolutely brilliant work at taking place, and it goes on every day to give our children the best possible start in life. Some really good stuff, and we should perhaps showcase more of it. Just to let everybody know, that our first of the new fleet of Mersey Rail's rolling stock will shortly be leaving Switzerland and will arrive in the city region at some stage, possibly before the new year. And finally, this week, we saw something fantastic. It was the transfer of the Borough of Culture from Wirral, who had a truly remarkable year, to Sefton Council. And to celebrate the success of Wirral's year as Borough of Culture, we're going to just show a short video. It's only on for a couple of minutes, but it just really does showcase and highlight